Welcome to the Arlington House, also known as the Custis Lee Mansion. The house was built by George Washington Park Custis, the step-grandson of George and Martha Washington. George Custis inherited the 1,100-acre estate from his natural father, John Park Custis, who died just after the Battle of Yorktown. George Custis built the original house between 1802 and 1818 on the highest point of the plantation. It was built not only as a home, but also as a memorial to George Washington. The Arlington House is one of the earliest Greek Revival structures inspired by a Greek temple. Its design features huge columns that span the entire two stories of the house, also known as colossal orders. The house was built by slaves on the plantation using handmade brick from the property's red clay soil and shells from the Potomac River. They covered the brick with a hydraulic cement and then painted a faux finish to look like marble and sandstone, which was popular in the early 1800s. The interior flooring and structural supports were harvested from the Arlington forest timber, which covered much of the property. Mr. Custis wanted the home to be a memorial to George Washington, as well as a safe place to display his collection of George Washington's memorabilia. The huge columned portico was intended by George Washington Park Custis to be prominent from the city. Each column is 23 feet tall and 5 feet in diameter. The house was constructed in many phases, with the north wing, built in 1802, the south wing in 1804, and the middle section and massive portico in 1818. The north wing was originally two stories with a large single chimney. Although the family lived in this section for many years, Mr. Custis planned to convert this into a large ballroom someday. The south wing was where they entertained guests and displayed the collection of George Washington's memorabilia. Construction of the largest section of the house, the two-story middle house and portico, was built in 1818. Arlington House had two kitchens. The summer kitchen was located in the lower level of the north slave quarters. The winter kitchen was in the basement of the north wing. George Custis was also a painter. He painted Revolutionary War battle scenes featuring George Washington and painted the murals of hunting scenes in the back hall of the house. Custis ran the plantation, but increasingly relied on his daughter, Mary Anna Custis, and her husband, Robert E. Lee, to handle the estate operations until George's death in 1857. The estate was then passed to Mary Custis, but not Robert E. Lee, who never owned the home despite living there for over 30 years. As the Civil War broke out in 1861, Robert E. Lee resigned from the U.S. Army and moved out of the residence. It took Mary Anna Custis a lot of convincing, but soon she departed, fearing for her safety. Union troops soon took over the property and set up a military camp. In 1863, the government established Freedmen's Village on the property to assist slaves transitioning to freedom. Over 1,000 former slaves were given housing, education, training, food, and medical care. The Lee family lost the home through a property tax dispute, and the federal government purchased the property in 1864 for almost $27,000. Mary and her daughters moved between several family plantations before settling in Richmond, where she spent most of the war confined to a wheelchair and in constant pain from arthritis. Robert E. Lee never set foot on the property again. Mary Custis did visit Arlington a few months before her death in 1873 at the age of 66. Unable to get out of the carriage, one of her former slaves brought her a drink of water from the well. In 1874, Lee's eldest son, George Washington Custis Lee, sued the United States, claiming ownership of property. The U.S. Supreme Court ruled that the estate had been confiscated without due process, so Congress returned the estate to Custis Lee. Ironically, the next year, Custis Lee sold it back to the government for $150,000, equal to $3.1 million today. If you look to the east, you'll see Memorial Bridge crossing the Potomac River, which was the boundary between the North and the South during the Civil War. It was built in 1933. As a symbol of reunification after the war by connecting Arlington House and the Lincoln Memorial. That concludes our tour of the Arlington House. Feel free to tour inside the home to see what life in the 19th century was like.